sort of satisfaction in this, when this division title this year after sort of grind the last few weeks?
Yeah, I mean, it's definitely special. I mean, it always is, though. I mean, it really is always is. It's cool to win the AFC West, but obviously dealing with some adverse situations over these last few weeks and for guys to respond against a good football team and find a way to win even when the game wasn't going in our way at the beginning of it, it was special. I told the guys celebrate it, enjoy it. I mean, our goal is obviously to continue to win, so we have to continue to build off this momentum and get ready for the playoffs.
It doesn't solve everything, I assume, but does it give you sort of a tangible feeling of, like, another accomplishment, a reset that helps you gain some momentum?
Yeah, I thought we did a lot of great things today. Offensively, I thought we did a good job of just letting the game come to us, not trying to force it, not trying to do too much. Obviously, we had the one fumble in the first half, but other than that, I thought guys did a great job. And yeah, we got to continue to get better in the red zone. But, I mean, Harrison Bucker, he saved us, man. He knocked through, I think, 6 field goals. And when you have a defense like that shutting the door, man, I mean, that's how you got to win football games.
The performances of Rasheed and Isaiah, both over 100 yards receiving and rushing. Talk to those performances today and how they helped you guys.
Yeah, I mean, that's guys stepping up and making plays happen. I mean, I thought the offensive line did a tremendous job in the run game. And then, obviously, Isaiah, when he gets through there, man, he's gone. And so he did a great job. Rasheed made a lot of big plays, especially in the second half. And that's what we're going to need when they have that much attention on Travis. For guys like that, they step up and make plays happen. And like I said, I thought guys just continued with it. They didn't, whenever stuff wasn't going our way, they didn't get down. They just continued with the process, and we were able to find a way to get a win.
Those plays are a little bit more rare now just because of the coverages you're seeing. One to Rice, I guess, how good did that feel, and what did you see in that play?
Yeah, I think they busted the a coverage. I think they were trying to get to 2. And they ended up having 2 guys playing on the same side as far as the safety in the corner. And so I was looking that way to think of possible like a hole shot, and then it just opened wide open. And I thought Rasheed did a great job of catching it and getting vertical. I told him, I'm going to teach him how to get those knees up, man. He's going to get in the end zone next time. But he did a great job, man. And I thought we had a couple other opportunities. And we try to take those shots today and back the defense off. And once you do that, it helps out with all the underneath stuff.
You've been in this spot every year since you've been here. Now, looking forward for a second, does it feel any different than any other year?
I mean, obviously the season hasn't been – we're not winning this in week 12 or week 13 like we have before. I mean, we had to battle through adversity and find a way to win this game, but it's not over. I mean, we have to continue to get better and better. We understand that. Kind of the motto of this season at the end of it has been a good game and a bad game. So how can we sustain and get stuff going and continue to build off this momentum and get that momentum going into the playoffs? And now, like I said, now you're in the playoffs. It's one game, single elimination, and I think we can go out there and compete with anybody.
She mentioned to me just some different options he had on that deep ball, but noticing that coverage, what do you think about his instincts to spot that before the snap? And then at what point do you know that he's got to be right where he's going?
Yeah, no, he definitely did. He did a great job recognizing coverage and converting the route and getting down the field. He does a great job of that. I mean, for the most part, I mean, he's pretty correct on reading coverages and not making the same mistake twice. And we ran a play early in the game. The game before, he ran in, and I missed him, and I was talking to him about it. And then we ran another play where he caught it and got vertical and kind of towards the red zone. It was the exact same play. And he did a great job of recognizing the coverage and learning from the previous week. And that's just kind of how he's been all year long. And I think that's why you see him continue to get better and better as the season goes.
Do for you guys as a team, as an offensive unit, to hit some plays downfield and look like the old Chiefs?
Yeah, I think guys just did a great job of attacking the defense. I mean, I think at the end of the day, it's me trusting those guys to go out there and make plays happen, and I put it out there, and guys made a lot of plays happen. So, I mean, that's just going to continue to build trust that I can go and do that, and I think it'll help open Travis up because there's so much attention on him in the middle of the field. And I think if we can show that we can go over the top and hit these deep passes, it'll open up him, and then we can kind of battle off that throughout the rest of the year.
Patrick, there was a report that you guys maybe simplified, kind of went back to basics on offense. Any truth to that? And do you feel like that helped if that's what you did?
Yeah, I think we still had a lot of the same similar plays. I think we just put guys out there and said, we're going to run the plays that we know. We're going to let y'all go out there and play fast. And then no thinking, let's just be us. And I think that helped guys play more free today. And then whenever stuff went wrong, we could bounce back quickly. It wasn't like we were like trying to fix it and figure out a different way to do this. It was, hey, we know these plays, we run these plays, and let the guys go out there and play fast and use their talent. I thought they did a great job of it.
Patrick, nothing against any of your other backs, but is there just a different energy when Pacheco's in the game?
I mean, I think he's a different energy than any other player on the entire team, man. I mean, the way he runs the football, the energy that he comes with, I don't think I've seen. There's like a small number of people that have that much intensity, and when they're running the football, you got like Marshawn Lynch, you got like Marion Barber, from all my old Cowboys days. I mean, it's to be able to run that hard all the time and have that much energy, it's a special type of player. And hopefully we'll be able to get Clyde back this next week, and I thought he's playing really good football as well, and so we can let those guys go out there and be them.
You're locked into the 3 seed. It looks like regardless of what happens next week against the Chargers, you've been in the position of both playing and resting in the final week of the season. Is there some benefit to you of being able to get some rest if that's the way it works out?
I didn't know that, but I kind of just let Coach Reed make all those decisions, and then I roll. So if he wants us to get out there and kind of build off this momentum that we have, I'll be ready to go. And if he wants to give us some rest, then I'll get that rest, prepare for whoever we're going to play, and I'll be ready to go in the playoffs.
Last two. You mentioned teaching Rashid to get his knees up. He has some separation on the knee.
No, he's fast. I think people don't understand that because haven't been able to utilize him downfield as much as we wanted to. But he definitely is fast. He's explosive. I told him he's in Dallas in the offseason. He's going to work out with me. I'm going to teach him how to get the knees up so he can build as he goes. He's very explosive in those first, like through a 40. But I got to, if we're going to get 80-yard touchdowns, man, we got to get those knees up and get down the field.
Last one, man.
Patrick, much of this season has been about the consistency of the defense. I just wonder from your perspective, how does the defense sort of motivate and inspire you when things aren't necessarily going as smooth on offense as perhaps you would hope?
Yeah, I mean, personally for me, I thought I let the defense down last week. I mean, they played their tail off, and I think everybody knows that. But the two turnovers that were 14 points. I mean, that changed the entire game, obviously. But I thought it just let the defense down. And so this week, I tried to do a great job. Obviously, we had the fumble. I tried to do a great job of just when it wasn't there deep, get it to underneath guys, try to get the first downs. If not, we can punt, man. Like, I know it's not how I've always rolled, but we can punt. The defense gets us the ball back, and we're gonna find ways to win football games. And so. I think if we execute in the red zone, we can put up more points than we did today. But other than that, man, I mean, it's true. It's a different feel. It's different, man. They have this good of a defense that shuts the door on some great offensive players. And so it's going to keep us in every single game. And it's going to be on the offense to go out there and score enough points to win them.
All right, thank you.